to be doing 4th of July this Saturday, on July the 7th. A lot of people have to go somewhere else for the weekend, and for the 4th of July, they're going, a lot of them are going out of town. Anyway, we're going to have a dinner down there Saturday. We're going to have brisket, hamburgers, hot dogs, a little bit of everything. Hopefully this time we don't get rained out. Anyway, we're going to have the Jason Ryan Band also going to be there to play. Two of them will be there to play, the other two are on vacation, but we will have music, entertainment. Retired Air Force Aubrey Crowell, he will be there to give an Independence Day speech. So we'd like everyone to come down and eat with us. It's just on a donation type deal. We're not charging nothing to eat. So anyone wants to come down and eat, be with us. We'd like you to come down. That's it.
Thank you, Mayor. Ms. Prue.
Oops. I just wanted to let everybody know that the Historical Commission, the Eastern County Historical Commission, had a workshop this past Saturday, and that we did two markers, one in Eastland, and we also refinished the one in the museum yard. Take, go by and take a look at it and see part of it was real bad, and looked real gray and dirty, so we cleaned it up. And also I might as well just say it while I'm here, the Ranch Rodeo was a success.
Thank you. Anybody else, anybody want to sign? Done. Okay, we'll move on to the next one then.
Yeah, they've been here for about 10 years. Here's some pictures from the okay. Marine 13, and the rest of them are more like you today.
Okay. I understand that you and Mr. Drew have got a timetable and have a plan set up on this.
What?
No. Dr. Drew, do y'all not have a plan set up on this?
No, somebody was supposed to have called me Friday, but they never called for one thing. But there's no timetable, they didn't say anything like that.
I wasn't aware of any.
Oh, okay. I thought y'all had a plan on this and told me that you had this lined up and ready to go.
Well, it's one of the leaks that I've heard about ever since I've been here. In a short 6 weeks, we have gotten inundated with things that have taken, I guess, a precedence or that. I'm not denying the fact that he's probably been treated unfairly over the years, and that this should have been resolved far sooner than now. My plan is this week to get some pipe laid out on the job site. I'll need to rent a excavator because of the moisture and the wetness of the property, so that we can get through there and not make a big rut and a big mess of things. I intend to lay a new pipe totally across this entire piece of property and then tie it in outside the fence on either side, to where that land would be totally isolated and dead on your property. I also will go back in and clean up the construction site, as well as clean up all the holes and stuff that were left by prior personnel working out there and repairing a leak and just leaving the hole open. He's got several holes on the property that need some cleanup and repair, and I'll be glad to do all of that. Hopefully within the next 3 weeks, we'll have the job totally finished. It's gonna take a few days to do. So that's a pretty good stretch.
You gonna put the lines on the outside of the building, outside of the bench then?
I'm gonna try. I'm getting locates done this week to see where the gas line is, where the telephone cables are, where the sewer line is, all that, and I wanna make a, then I'll make a concerted effort to stake it out and do it. And hopefully I can be outside your fence, yes.
I have a real concern that that's going to be a problem. I really do.
I'm sure it is.
It's so full of things and everything to get in there, and that is a major transmission line for the telephone. It's not just one little small telephone. It's a big one. No, I mean, I would like for it to be outside, but I'm not sure that that's...
Well, the other thing to consider too is if we go outside his property line, I will need to deal with the TxDOT and get a state permit to deal on their right of way.
Okay.
I'll have to get a permit from the state TxDOT to deal work on their property, And I don't have an objection to that if everything works out, but we should be, you'll see some stakes and flags in the next few days as we get locates done and all that. And then I'll give you a call and we'll work out the other details as to when we can come in and if it's on your property or right outside your property. Then I assure you, we'll clean up your property and fill the holes and everything that's there now.
It's all a big rage.
Okay, sir. Thank you for you.
That side of the road's outside the sea limits, right?
There's been some description of who owns that road. It's in our files that the county owns it. So if you're gonna get in the board ditch right away, you gotta get a permit.
Yes.
All right. We have fixed that road to the corner.
Yeah.
We spent a fortune on it. So, and it's in the files, in my files, that it is a county road. So that stops all this nonsense of county owns this half or that side or we own. So if you're gonna do any work in the board ditch right away, you gotta have permits. You gotta get with me.
That's what I'm saying, I'm aware of that.
No problem.
But he's talking about the board ditch on 254, not on Tom County Road, is where he's talking about.
I'm talking about county road. County road is county. Road with the board ditch.
Okay.
County road.
We'll pull permits as we need them there, absolutely.
There's a, it's work in progress. You know, we're definitely, it's definitely getting our attention and we're gonna see the project through. There's no action needed on that for the council.
Okay.
Just make you aware that Mr. Schoenfeld had a concern.
Okay. We'll be a motion to take no action.
Lady at the nursing home over here is having a gathering and a good time for the patients that are there and not the main street in front. Highway 101, that's not going to be closed, it's the two side streets. She wants to close those from 11 to 2 on Friday. So she can have a little more activity and get the people outside to see. They're going to have a cotton candy machine and maybe some little games and some things like that and everything over there. This causes no major traffic problem for the city of Range or any pass through traffic. So I'd like to see this happen if we can. We get a motion on that. Or have any discussion.
Is that just the one block on each side?
One block on each side, right there on either side of the nursing home.
Okay. I'll make that motion.
I'll say that. We have a motion to close those two streets for July the 1st. Motion the 2nd.
11 a.m. and 2 p.m.
11 a.m. 2 p.m. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion passes. Agenda item number 7. Discuss, consider the opening and awarding of a bid on real estate property owned by the city of Ranger and being in 3.5 acres more or less out of abstract 156 Mark Haley survey located behind Pine Street that was advertised in the Eastern County newspaper on June the 9th and June the 16th.
Mr. Mayor, we did receive two sealed bids within that time frame before the deadline.
June the 24th and one on June the 32nd.
We have the 23rd.
Okay, I'm going to open the one on the 23rd.
It was dyslexic a little bit.
Bid for abstract 156 Mark Haley Survey Ranger J.I. Cole T.R. Not sure what that is. That amount is $3,601 for for Mr. Ronnie Rutledge, post office box 454 in Ramsey.
$3,601?
$1. And this one came in on the 24th. Abstract 156, Mark Haley Survey. The bid is $7,000 for Mark and Green. Questions or comments?
The only thing I'd like to say is that that does go above the appraised value, so there it'd be.
$7,000 is the high bid on that. And I see no reason not to award that to the highest bid.
Correct. Be recommendation of the city administrator to award the bid.
Can I say something?
Yes, ma'am.
Barbara Rutledge. The article in the paper said the bids had to be submitted prior to the 24th.
Yes, by 5 p.m.
Prior to the 24th, so wouldn't that cut off to the 23rd?
No, it was supposed to go through 5 o'clock on Friday.
Did you say prior to 5 p.m. on Friday?
Yes, it does.
It says prior to 5? Okay.
Prior to Friday, June 24th, 2016.
Thank you.
Prior to.
Okay. Any other questions? Okay. We'll award the bid to Ms. Green for $7,000.
Thank you very much.
No action taken on following topics without specific notice. These items include expressions of thanks, congratulations, condolences, information on holiday schedules, recognition of public officials, employees, or citizens other than employees or officials whose status may be affected by the council through action. Reminders of the community events or announcements involving an imminent threat to the public health and safety of people in the municipality. Have anything?
I do want like to say something. I really want to say how much we appreciate you. I'm not just speaking for me, many, many others. You know how many people have walked up to me and said, Chad is doing a great job. And so I just want to thank you. I hope you hang in there. Anything that we can do, that I can do as a council member or as a private citizen, let me know. Please. Thank you, Chad.
I have a comment also along the same lines. From different people, but we had a gentleman that came in here and complained about wastewater standing that had been leaking for a long time in the back of his property. And he told me that that had been cleaned up, and his friend, a friend of mine, these are people that I know, said also that that operation was looking so much better. And I know a lot of that, and I always give you the credit, as well as Joe, but when the citizens notice that things are getting better and things are actually getting done quicker and more completely, that goes to the reputation of the city, and I love that we're getting, it's not me that can take that, because I didn't do it for sure, but I really appreciate you, and I encourage you that I know you work hard, and I really appreciate everything you did.
Definitely.
And Roger Drew's just
some words. I'm about to do the same thing. Roger really probably had as much or more to do with that getting that
grant up and taking care of anyone.
Thank you, Roger.
Yes, very much. And I would like to say one more thing, too, about a compliance officer. Would that not be a great idea for us to do that? I mean, you know, with all the stuff that's coming in on the interstate out there, if we don't get our town cleaned up, they're not going to want to come in. So this has really got to happen.
Right.
We really got to get busy, especially on that loop, and get everything cleaned up. A compliance officer, possibly from not this town, so that he can't say, oh, I know Joe Blow over here, but I can't, you know, do that to him.
Yep.
Let's get someone that's from out of town that doesn't know anybody here.
We
we currently have someone in that position.
Oh, good. You know, wonderful. You're ahead of us, as usual.
I was wondering that, I don't know what it's called, but I know that it's the water well, the waterway that goes in between the fire station and the Veterans Park that got so full recently with all that great rain that we had. And they're working across the street from it with the caterpillar or whatever that equipment is. I'd like to know what.
Commissioner Deaver. That's my land.
Okay, I just wanted to talk to the back pitch of it during that heavy rain. What are we doing? Can we deepen that waterway, or is there anything we can do? Because it looked like.
I'm widening it up and make it deeper, also clean out all the trash. Just clean it all this year or two.
Doesn't that go directly into
Hayden
Lake and then further down?
And that's something we're looking into, FEMA and stuff like that also.
Yeah, he's working on his property on the north side of 254. Where you're talking about is on the south side of 254.
Yeah.
And it does need to be trenched or cleaned out to help flow through what he's looking for. Even though when it gets to him, it flows better, it's still going to back up.
Well, it seems to come down. Maybe I've been looking at it backwards.
It actually flows from south to north.
South to north.
Yes, it does.
In that one area, it does. It's not normal. Yes, it does.
That's how the Hagman Lake gets its water. It goes south to north. That's the Hagman Lake.
Yeah.
Oh. Is there any other announcements?
Oh. I have three things. Today, the city got served with the local option election petition for all alcohol, so that's something that will be certified and then sent back out for them to get enough signatures to get it on the ballot. So can you maybe come in with the council to go to a special election this November?
Great.
City hall hours, we're open from 8 to 5, so we're open 9 hours a day now. We don't close for lunch. For the convenience of the citizens, ones that are on their lunch hour or anything, come by and drop off the water payments. So Monday through Friday, 8 to 5. And then the TxDOT and the Ranger Historical Commission are going to do a ribbon cutting, dedication and ribbon cutting on Thursday, July 21st at 11 a.m. for the TxDOT rest stop areas. So, yes, ma'am.
Can I correct something?
You sure can. Please do.
The Eastland County Historical Commission and the Ranger Historical Preservation Society did the Bankhead Highway part of that. This is the TxDOT and the Chamber of Commerce.
Okay, that's right.
Yes.
Yeah. So everybody's invited to attend that on July 21st at 11 a.m. I think it's going to be a real neat deal.
Yes, it's those roadside parks are going to be an extra benefit to the city as far as being able to just get everybody to stop and say hello, and maybe get somebody to stop in town and buy something along the way or something. That doesn't look so popular. A little bit of gasoline or something.
Yep.
Any other announcements, anything else? Okay, just a kind of a clean house thing here with us. After tonight, we're going to move you two ladies to this side over here, and we're going to put the administrator and the city secretary here. So they say they can whisper in my ear. In case I'm doing something wrong.
Yes, like what we
do. So I can keep him straight.
But us girls will be together.
Yeah, the girls will be together over there, the boys over here. I guess I'll make a rest.
Segregation? That's all right.
We'll have to mix them now.
All right. Anybody else have anything else? Okay, let's move on to agenda item number. That's number 8, number 9. Discuss, consider a resolution declaring October 15th, 2017 through October 21st, 2017, Ranger Boomtown Week, and declaring Central Texas Historical and Genealogical Preservation Week, or DBA, Ranger Historical Preservation Society, as the official organizer's host of the Ranger Boomtown Centennial Celebration, an event to include but not limited to the theatrical performances portrayed short excerpts Ranger's historical history up to the blowout of the J.H. McCluskey No. 1 Discovery Well, music and entertainment, old-fashioned county fair,
talent contest, parade, and much more, inviting our surrounding communities and neighbors to take part, showing how the boom affected their respective communities. Good.
Okay. We need to get this started, and in order to actually be getting the funding, and the, well, first of all, we've got to get it lined out, that all the committees and all of that know what funding we needed, and then of course, we know the advertising already, but, and several other things. But
the resolution is on the back here, on the very last page of your package. The only word that was struck through there was the word huge under funding parade.
Yeah, that's out. Anyway, we just need to get this so we can go ahead with our planning. And it sounds like a year, a little over a year is a long time, but when you're putting something of this magnitude together, you really need to make sure you've got plenty of time and you don't want to wait till the last minute. So I appreciate it if y'all will pass the resolution.
Okay. Anybody have any questions or comments?
I was curious, and it's just a friendly question. Do we have any kind of expected expenses on this project?
You want me to tell you what I think? I mean, of all the expenses, I believe. Well, first of all, you've got advertising. And a full-page ad on the back of the newspaper is over $3,000.
That's all your money, nearly.
Ma'am?
I said that's a lot of money.
Yes, it is. We have the other things, part of the history portrayals. We've got 38 acres that this is going to be done on. And it will be, we will have some buildings up, like portable buildings portraying the courthouse, the first courthouse, or the Texas Ranger cabin. Those things that are collapsible where you can take them down, those things are part of the expense. But if you would like, when I get this, I mean, I don't mind at all giving you an idea once we get into it of the exact, well, the close to exact, you never know, because you always have things that crop up.
And this large of an effort is pretty much a first thing, and you've done things.
Yes, the closest we came to that was the very first thing I ever did was in April of 1994 when a former mayor had asked me to put together a celebration for the 75th anniversary of Rangers Incorporation. And we were going to do something of this magnitude, but we didn't have the time to do that. That's why right now, I've been gathering information for this for over 5 years. Knowing that it's coming up and knowing that what it's going to take to put it together. And we invite anybody who wants to be a part of this to, when we start putting things in the paper, asking for committees and whatever, just march your little self right in there and add your name. We don't mind at all. In fact, we welcome anyone. Any other questions for me?
Is this the 100th celebration of the city?
No.
Or
no, this is the 100th anniversary. Okay. October of 1917 is when the Plessy Well came in.
Well, okay.
And next October 2017 will be 100 years. That's the same thing.
The city
is
in 1919.
Right.
Yeah, 3 years later.
Before?
No, 2 years later.
Oh, okay.
After the well.
1919. Well, I thought that the city was here before the well. No.
The town was here.
It was a town.
Okay. Community.
City charge.
Okay.
City charge.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
April of 1919.
All right. Does anybody want to make a motion? Make a motion to approve agenda item number 9.
Second.
motion, do we have a second?
I second.
We have a motion and a second to approve agenda item number 9. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion passes. And I want to congratulate you on starting early.
Thank you.
That's thinking ahead and getting started. Agenda item number 10. Discuss and consider a request for the Ranger Historical Preservation Society for approval of expenditures up to $3,500 from the Hotel Motel Tax Fund to help with promotion of the advertising of Ranger Boomtown Centennial Celebration the week of October 15th through October 21st. Funds are to be made available as receipts are presented. Okay. Anybody have any comments on this or questions? The first question everybody's going to have is, does it qualify to come out of the Hotel Motel Tax as requested? And yes, it does, because the biggest qualification to that is, if you're putting something on in town, is it going to put heads in beds? And there's going to be people here during that time, whether they're participants or guests or whatever, there's going to be people coming to town during that time. We only have a limited number of hotel rooms and one thing or another, but what's there will be occupied during that time.
Well, I think personally that that's an awful lot of money to spend for your advertising, $3,500. I know you said a while ago it was X amount of dollars for a full page. Maybe you don't need
that. That's just one newspaper service.
I know, but maybe you don't need that, all that advertising. You know, there's other advertisings that you can do. The radio station here in Eastland, the KTAB, Fort Worth Telegram, K-Texas, Alpha.
Have you ever done any of this?
Yeah. Okay. Advertise. Actually, let's see, I wrote down here, there's you can have three spots a day for 7 days for $270 on our radio station in Eastland.
Okay, is that going to reach people that are in Dallas and Fort Worth and
Abilene? You can do the KTAB in K-Texas is the Abilene local news. Right. You can also do the Fort Worth Telegram, which is a pay, and I'm sure that their news would put you on as well. That's all free.
Excuse me, but I have done this for a lot of years, and I do know the ones that I can do for free. You can do press releases for free. But when you go advertise, they want money.
Oh, this is like, I know, I think the airport even does it. They use these people to do community.
I even have magazines that I can do for free.
Community events, and that's what this would be.
Yes, but you're talking also about a week-long event that has got to be advertised. And I'll guarantee you that we will present receipts.
That's another thing too. I'd like to see a line item budget. That's what I want to see. And I mean, I'm not going to vote for it unless I see a line item budget. I want to know before. I don't want you coming in and saying, okay, I spent this much money, you pay for it now. I want to see that before you had offered to give that to
Okay.
Let me do an explanation on a couple of things here. The way this is worded, this says up to $3,500 on there. And currently in here we have $21,140 in here. This is money that can only be spent for advertising or bring more people to town or do something like this on there. So, I mean, it absolutely falls into that category as far as with that. And she's not asking for the full $35,000 and anything at this time. What she's asking is $3,500.
She's going to cost about $35,000.
She's not asking for that at this time or anything. She's asking to be able to spend up to that amount of money.
If it's necessary.
That's what she's looking for. It's kind of a backstop to the money that she's trying to earn and get together and do it all. Because I'll guarantee you, you're probably talking closer to $35,000, in order to advertise it properly and do it in that range. But she's going to be raising that money for another thing here. $3,500 out of what we have here is what?
You can spend as much money as you want. on advertising. You can spend as little. I'm just saying that I think that $3,500 is an awful lot of money to spend on advertising. So.
It is a lot of money. And like she said, she will have receipts and will have a budget ready for that. All she's asking for is the backdrop of coming having up to that amount. Or if she spends $2,250, is all that she spends and sends receipts, that's all we're going to give her is $2,250. It's not like she's going to get the $35 and spend it as she wishes.
When will you start advertising? Because this is a year.
Well, first of all, I've got the resolution has just been passed.
Yes, I know.
So now I can sit down and I can plan and I can go to these things. Like I said, I've been gathering information for over 5 years. I know what it's going to take for the advertising and put this thing on will be more than just local. We're not just going to do local advertising. And I know what I can get for free, and I get everything I can for free. I guarantee it.
Well, again, like I said, if you want to go to Abilene for
I might even ask your business for a donation. Yeah, there
well,
you go.
Yeah, we might give you a donation. But I would want to know what you're spending your money on.
And we will know. Absolutely.
Offer us a line item budget before you start paying or before you start.
I'm not going to commit to what you're asking for right now. Okay. I am going to set this out, and I'm going to figure out what
I do. That's fine. I don't care when you bring it in. That you can bring it in anytime you want. I'm not asking for it tonight. You know, that's why I think
no,
that we
I
should.
Said, I'm gonna,
I would
I'm,
like to make a motion that we table it and see what happens later. Maybe you can bring this in too. Because that's what I'm going to make a motion that we table line item.
Second.
On our agenda, I guess.
Are we looking at a timeline here?
That's what I'm looking for. Or more information on how the money's going to be spent is what I'm looking for.
Well, this will be in October, so.
October of
I
next
would
year.
Say,
not this,
yeah.
Not this year, October.
Yeah.
We've got a whole year.
So, for the time deal,
yeah.
You're putting off a year and some months.
And I'm going to put it to y'all this way, in particular to you, I'm going to do this with or without the city's help. But I think it would be very nice if the city would do its part to help us put this on, because it is for the city of Ranger.
I agree.
I'm not doing it for Jeannie Pruitt. I want you to know that.
That's fine. I agree with you. I think the city should help.
Yeah.
I just think $3,500 is a good match, and I would like to see what you're going to spend it for. That's all I'm saying, council members, if y'all want to.
Yep. Mayor, you have a motion on the floor.
Okay.
I never got a second. Die for lack of a second.
Well, I think that we do need to do this. I would like to see it, but my concern is we don't want to forget about it because this is something that the council wants to support. We're just asking for information about specifics as it becomes available. It can be in an approximation or just a list of necessary things that we know we're going to need for this, but we do want to support it.
Okay, let me ask this. If we find that the advertisement with a line item budget goes more than $3,500, do you think that would be something that you would want to be able to be a part of?
No, I don't. I don't want to be a part of $3,500 at all.
Okay.
I think that's too much money. That's what I'm saying. I think $3,500 is too much money to spend for advertising.
Okay. So line item or not, line item budget or not, you're not happy with it. You're
well,
not going to vote for it.
Maybe you could. So, maybe you could get it down, Jeannie.
I tell you what. Why don't y'all go ahead, Mr. Mayor, go ahead and table this. It's all right with me. Go ahead and table it. And then we will talk about it later. I'll get with the city administrator and see what he thinks I ought to do about it.
Well, I think the council has the last word.
We'll find a say on there.
Well, I put the item on there. I can take it off if I want to.
But I mean, we have the last say. We have the last
Mayor,
say.
Mayor, I'd like to see a vote on the city council to approve the request And there may only be three that vote for it, or four, I don't know, but can't we just go to a, make a motion?
We have a motion on the floor, we're gonna have to either let it die or not.
It's already got it.
Motion tabled it for right now.
You've already asked to table it? All right, it's been asked to be tabled by the representative of this program on there, so at that time, I think at this time, then I guess we will table it.
I need a second.
Need a second to table.
I second.
Well, you agree? She agreed to.
She didn't withdraw, but it has to be the council.
Okay, that's fine.
So we have a motion, do we have a second?
I'll second.
We have a motion and a second to table at this time, all those in favor say aye. Opposed? Motion passed.
Does there have to be a line item on that? Aren't there some other things that you have a line item on what they're taking and what they're spending for what?
What they're taking and spending for?
Well, there's never anything said about what has been spent for what.
Well, if you, I know you didn't have a copy of what we did here tonight as far as some of the budgets, not budget items, but the profit loss and the statements of that. Pretty much everything that's happening now is being done that way.
Even the organizations that are under this council?
Well, before we talk about other organizations, I don't know about that, ma'am, on their top.
Well, A&B, Economic Development?
Yeah, but,
I have no further business to tell.
I make a motion with Jerry.
All right. Motion second to adjourn.